Well, let's speak now on the program as well to Sami Nader. He is the head of the Levant Institute for Strategic Affairs. He joins us live from Beirut as well. Good afternoon to you and thank you for joining us today. Tell us, first of all, about the last 2 days from where you stand. Would you say that Israel and Hezbollah are now in a state of all-out war?
I mean, we crossed the red line and we are today into a full-blown war. It's not anymore the tit-for-tat type of war that was prevailing for the last year. It's today, it's an all-out war, similar to the one that happened in 2006. In the last 2 days, it took a very dangerous turn because the civilians are in the line of fire. And what we have seen this huge wave of displaced of migration is alarming for a country that is already going through a deep economic and financial crisis, a country that is totally divided across sectarian lines. So this does not bode well for the future. All the diplomatic efforts to reach a solution have failed so far. The position of the parties are very far apart. In a nutshell, Israel wants to change the rule of engagement as they were prevailing in before October 7th. While Hezbollah is determined to go back to the rules of engagement before the October 7th, it's from the Israeli point of view, it's an existential a threat. They need to facilitate the return of the residents of the Galilee, while Hezbollah is keep insisting on linking the war he decided to wage on October 8th to a ceasefire in Gaza. And there is no indicator whatsoever that a ceasefire in Gaza is reachable, at least in the very short term.
Well, let's talk about Hezbollah's response then. I mean, the group has had a really quite devastating 2 weeks. We saw its communications infrastructure badly hit in those pager attacks. A number of top commanders have been killed. We are just hearing today that perhaps another one has been killed in a new strike this afternoon on Dahye. How badly do you think that has damaged Hezbollah's ability now to conduct this war?
I mean, Hezbollah is at its worst point ever. I mean, this is an organization that in 2006 managed to defeat one Israel, one of the strongest army in the region, not to say the strongest army and one of the strongest army in the world. Today, it's noticeable how much Hezbollah arsenal is totally exposed to Israel's secret services. And one additional important point is that Israel was getting prepared to this military operation against Hezbollah. It's true that it has been surprised by Hamas attack on October 7th, but since July 2006 and since what they consider a defeat, they have been preparing to recover and refurbish their image of and their deterrence. And the proof of that is the pager operation. The pagers operation, I mean, now it's well known that it has been prepared for 15 years. And so we are in a situation where Hezbollah seems to lose the deterrence, where Israel is proving its dominance at the, at least at the technological level, and for a war that is taking more and more the dimension of a technological warfare.
And I'm interested what you think about how much support Hezbollah has now within Lebanon. You mentioned earlier the 2006 war. It was thought at the time that Hezbollah had quite a bit of support from the Lebanese population, not just from those who are sort of traditionally within the community that support Hezbollah. So now, I mean, you talk about an organization that suffered huge setbacks. Do you think that there are Lebanese people out there who are angry with Hezbollah, who blame them for what we're seeing in Lebanon today?
You know, before the event of the last 2 days, I mean, Hezbollah has been criticized for having decided this war on its own, for having blocked the election of a president in Lebanon, capturing the whole state institution, for blocking the investigation about concerning the Beirut port blast. However, the last events, we have seen a sign of solidarity, and namely vis-a-vis the civilians that were killed, the innocent civilians that were killed, especially yesterday, more than 500 people have been killed, and 1,000 have left their homes. And you can sense a feeling of solidarity among the Lebanese people towards some of the constituency of Hezbollah, and of course, vis-a-vis the Shia community in general.
Let's talk about the Lebanese government, because there are lots of people who see Lebanon effectively now as a failed state amid a devastating economic crisis, the port explosion that you already mentioned as well. Does the Lebanese government at this point have the capacity to protect its citizens in any way from what is going on?
Definitely. The Lebanese army has the capability, and it has proven the capability when it was fighting the ISIS section in the aftermath of the Syria war. However, this Lebanese army needs a political decision, and what we are witnessing today is a political void. There is no government in place. The current government is a caretaking government that is under the spell of Hezbollah, let's face it. So there is no political decision to back up the Lebanese army, and this is the only exit of this crisis, is to go back to the UN resolution, namely the 1701, and to entrust the Lebanese army to control the borders hand in hand with the international forces, and there are more of 10,000 of international soldiers at the borders between Lebanon and Israel.
Sami Nader talking to us there live in Beirut. Thank you very much indeed, sir, for your analysis this afternoon.